exactly 40 years ago, in 1977. This was after I was in the Army Entertainment Group, the Nachal, and that's why I was really wanted to be the drummer in the movie, because the songs, the last song, Shir LaShalom, Song of Peace, I'm playing in it. By the way, I'm also playing in the drums in the record, so the whole movie. So before that, I was after the Army group, I played in a group called Poogie. Have you heard about Poogie?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Everybody heard? Oh, that's good. Okay. Sorry? With Giddy Gov, yeah?
Kaveret,
yeah. Giddy Gov is the only one from Poogie right here, right? Yeah. And after that, after Poogie disbanded in 1976, I was the only one that didn't want to leave the group. I really tried to hold the group, not to disband, and didn't work for me. And I'm the only one that not in the music. All of them, six of them, are still right now playing. Music is their life. Music is not my life anymore. I'm doing the festival almost for 35 years. I started it when I came to Boston College of Music, and I thought to myself, after I played in this movie, I played in another movie called Aunt Clara, and I played in a theater in the Chan HaYerushalmi for a year. I got confused. I didn't know which direction I want to be, an actor, in the movies, in the theater. I want to go to music, but I wanted to cut my own record. So I went to Boston to study music. And after a year, I find myself doing arrangement for six instrument, but that's not what I want to do. I wanted to cut a record, my own record, but I didn't want to arrange to a 32-piece band. So a professor from BU, Boston University, that did a sabbatical, they say, right? Yeah. In Israel, asked me if I know anybody in Israel that can help him to bring two movies to Boston. And I said, I know somebody, Menachem Golan, that already passed away, if you heard about him. And I met him, and I said, I'm looking for two movies. He said, it's going to cost you $3,000. Two movies? I said, $3,000? I'm paying $1,500 tuition. What do you want for two screenings, so much money? He said, that's the price. And then somebody asked me there in his office, are you putting together a festival? I said, no. What's the festival? He said, take me, I'm going to do you advertising, marketing, you know. I said, you know what, it's a not bad idea. What do you mean a festival? He said, take six films and, you know, put together, you know, a festival, 4 days, 6 days. We'll talk about it. If you're interested, I can help you. And I went back to Boston, and then the idea kind of got into me, and I went to Toronto Film Festival. I heard that there's somebody is putting at the Toronto Film Festival, a Jewish film festival, and she basically taught me what is a film festival, you know, the timing and everything that to put together a festival, and I got really excited about it, and suddenly my life changed. I was only going to school, to music, doing, but my head was really, how do I put together this festival? I did a four-day festival in Boston. This is 1982, I think. And what happened is very interesting. In the first day of the festival, by the way, it was $35,000. And tuition was $1,500 and was kind of hard. So I took on myself $35,000 to put together. It was really crazy. Like, it didn't make any sense. I knew that I'm going to lose my shirt. And I didn't know what to do after that. But what happened is, in the first screening of the film, a doctor came to me and said, are you planning to advertise in the Boston Globe? I said, no. He said, why not? Every Jew in Boston should know, this is great what you're doing. You have to advertise. This is a lot of money, Boston. It's like LA Times. I cannot advertise it. I'll pay for it. Where's the ad? That come, I have a little desk in a basement somebody gave me. I'll give you an ad. He put an ad in the quarter page, probably $2,500 at that time. That's what cost me the whole theater. So for me too. And Sunday, five screenings. I had two screenings on Wednesday, two screenings on Thursday, two screenings on Saturday, but five screenings on at the Coolidge Corner in
Brookline. Brookline.
In Brookline, yeah. 600 seats, 3,000 people came. Full houses, all the five screenings, just because of this little ad. And I came out with money. Came out with $15,000 from the festival. And I said, my God, I did it in Boston, I have to do it now in New York. 2 weeks later, I took a U-Haul, I was on my way to New York, I said bye-bye to the school, I'm gonna do it now in New York. And I did the first one in New York, and then there I have even more problems, not because of the people, it's because it was January, I think, and it was icy. The street was ice, not snow, it was ice. And on 42nd Street, a truck just closed the whole street, and I walked from 28th Street to 59th Street, no subways, everything closed. And I was sure that it's not gonna be opening night, forget it, it's not gonna happen. I came, 400 people, full house. I said, impossible, how did this happen? But it happened. And that's basically what takes me every year from each festival to another, up till now, 31 years here in Los Angeles. So thank you very much for coming and sharing my story.
Any questions?
Are you on questions? Yes, please.
I know a lot of the actors in this movie
are
really in La Côte à Trois-Îles.
Right.
Including yourself.
Right.
Had you known any of these people beforehand? I know Gidi Govan, you were in the same.
Right.
But any of the others, Stassi Keshet?
I knew them, but you know, nobody was kind of a big star at that time. They were known, but not. Stassi Keshet was pretty known. He was also in La Côte à Nahal. He already did a couple of. Sorry?
At the same time as you?
No, he's before me.
He's before you?
Yeah, I think 2-3 years before me. What's her name? Singer?
Gali
Atari, still singing.
Yeah.
Pretty good. I mean, she's getting better. She's not young, but she's really keeping up. She's doing very well. People love her.
Yeah, she's still there.
Yeah. Yes.
I